Greeting once more, fellow PokéTubers. This is Geodude, and we are pushing onwards. As you can tell, it is deep in the nighttime. If you want to know just how deep into the nighttime, that's how deep into the nighttime. But all of our Pokémon, including our recently acquired Mira, are all up to level 9. So we're going to be pushing through Oreburgh Tunnel into Oreburgh itself. And we're going to try and get ourselves a gym badge by the end of this episode. Yay, gym badge. There will be 2 more captures before the battle proper. I'm comfortable as is with 3 Pokemon with type advantage. One of my provisional rules is my Pokemon cannot be above the level of the gym leader's highest level Pokemon, which is 14. So I'm going to be trying to keep my Pokemon between 12 and 13 for that fight. If I do end up with one above level 14, I can't use them. Unless all my other Pokemon are dead. So, yeah. But we're just going to make a quick bum rush to the cave. Pokemon will not be the only game I'll be playing. It'll just be one of the main ones. Because I have like 200 some odd video games on Steam, so I'm definitely going to be playing a good chunk of my Steam games on here too. Moving onwards. I'm gonna crush you beneath my heel. And then I'm gonna pop in Don't matter. Yeah, Mara's ability on top of that is Tamp, which is glorious. Because I can't remember if any of his Pokemon know self-destruct. If they do, it don't matter. Welcome to Oreburgh. I think you snot-nosed little turd. Away! Mines of Nuzlocke. There it is. And doop. Quick heal up. Now we're gonna see who catch number one is. with the route just a little to the north. Sturdy, but I don't want to risk it. So we'll do this the long way. That's burning scratches. My capture. Another Geodude. This one's a Geodudette. So, the scratches begin once again. Excuse me. Not entirely sure that I might pick that up, but better safe. hit point by hit point. There we go. Click. Some Pokeballs off of this one. Starting to run a little low. Yeah. Hello, Thilda. Now for death and destruction. At least it wasn't a Zubat. I was actually hoping for something like a Nomix, but... what ifs? This next one's gonna be a switching bait. Oh, never mind. I'll get that thing on the way out. Switch bait. And yeah. It's been a while since you've been up at the front of the party. Suck it dry. Quad damage. This one can rocket. Had the ability to rocket. Boo doo. Of importance. your soul to drink dry. Which I'm gonna skip. Run away! And talk to you. Nope. This is why I don't like games too much. Holy cow, you're a high level. Yep, I'm fine. Are now just now reaching level 10, so. There's gonna be a slight switch from norm. As I put a type advantage to the front. So freaking fast. I'm surprised they're able to learn this. However, sorry, Rain. You're gonna be HM slave more likely. Where were you earlier? Because I wanted you. Be able to do that early, soon myself. After I destroy you. Death and destruction, death and destruction. Alright, here's another fight. Unfortunately, Azef is the only one who has yet to gain a level. Might have to do a bait and switch. because you don't have any move able to do anything. So, we'll switch you to bottom rod. This FF can deal with. Should be able to, at least. Get all you're in. And then start the tackles. Boost. Yeah, it's gonna be a 3 turn. Half if it's level 10, maybe more. And I'm just gonna straight up GTFO. That one. Whirly, 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 whirly. So this way we go. Straight into focus center. And this is probably where I'll end it. Next episode, we'll be fighting the gym proper. And do a little grindage behind the scenes. Keep you guys updated if any deaths occur, which I hope won't happen, considering at least half of my team is strong against this next gym. But this is Geodude, signing off.